semen retention, unintentional motivation. You know, one of the biggest things that helps motivate me on my semen retention journey is low vibrational women. When I constantly see on a regular day basis low vibrational women, it motivates me to continue my journey, continue my path on semen retention, because I have attracted so much, man. I have implemented the law of attraction with my semen retention. And let me just tell y'all, Kings, I'm out here in Los Angeles and I'm living my dreams. You know, I'm not where I want to be just yet, but I'm everywhere I need to be. You know, I'm exactly where I need to be, excuse me. And actually, I am where I want to be, because anybody who practices semen retention, the law of attraction, let me slow down. Anybody who practices the law of attraction knows you have to speak things into existence. You have to speak things as if they are already happening and they are already here. So actually, I am where I want to be, right? 100%. And still growing and still improving. But back to what I'm saying. Unintentional motivation for me on semen retention is when I see so many low vibrational women around me, it just makes me realize, man, how lucky I am, how fortunate I am, how blessed I am to be on this journey, man. Because when I look at the alternative, bro, it's no comparison. When I got a homeboy, right, and he's a ladies man, you know, he's down here in Los Angeles as well. And he's a ladies man, and you know, he deals with all type of women. You know, he deals with beautiful women. And when he bring these women around, man, there's just so much motivation, because when you see how trash these women are, man, when you just see nowadays, it is really it's really quantity over quality, man. Like, it's just like everybody just fucking everything, man. Everybody just, you know, I'm seeing like beautiful women come over, man, and they willing to just do whatever, bro. Like, it's just like he meet these women on day naps, and it's not just him, you know, it's everybody, right? It's the generation we live in, it's the culture we live in. They meet women on day naps, women meet men on day naps, and they just link up and they drink and they smoke and they fuck. And man, when I'm around that shit, bro, even though I'm not engaging in that shit, bro, it's draining, bro. It's like, it just even being around it, it's not draining for me because I'm on my path, but it's just like draining in the sense of, it's just like, man, this shit is trash, right? It just makes me realize how trash shit is and how everybody's living at a lower nature, bro, at a lower frequency, right? A lower vibration. And it really motivates me that much more to be like, man, this is why you have to stick to this shit, bro, because you're not missing out on shit. You know, most people, even probably the old me, like me before I found myself, man, me before I started semen retention, NoFap, me before I implemented the law of attraction, meditation, right? Will probably feel like I was missing out because these beautiful women are coming through ready to get fucked. And I will probably feel like, damn, I could be doing the same thing, right? And would start doing the same thing. But where I'm at now in life, man, I don't know if it's just that, or it could also just be, man, getting older. You know, as we get older, hopefully not everybody, but a lot of us mature, right? So maybe it could be just me getting older as well. But man, I actually feel bad for not just the women, the men as well. I feel bad for both parties. I just feel bad, like, man, if this is all y'all have to look forward to in life, I feel sorry for y'all. You know, I don't feel like I'm missing out on shit. You know, just to get a little cocky and talk my shit, I feel like y'all missing out. Because if y'all see what I have manifested and what I have been able to attract through the law of attraction, semen retention, meditation, you will realize, like, man, it can't even compare to a piece of vagina. A piece of vagina cannot compare to what I have been able to manifest in my life by retaining my semen, right? By holding myself to a higher standard, by no longer watching pornography, no longer masturbating, and starting my meditation, right? So unintentionally, I become motivated by watching these interactions. Now I have a little story time for you. The other day I was at Walmart. This older lady comes up to me, begins to flirt with me, right? My homeboy's with me. He kind of senses she's flirting as well. You know, I try to kind of like blow her off. I held small talk with her, but we were standing in line, you know, due to COVID-19. You know, they make you stand in line outside now. So we were standing in line. So every time I would move up, obviously she's right behind us, so she would move up. But she was one of these people, man, and I'm pretty sure she probably sensed my energy from semen retention and being at a higher frequency that would not let go, right? Another distraction. You know, I'm very aware of what's going on out here, you know, definitely spiritually. So I know why she was put there. You know, she was put there to knock me out my path. But anyway, so every time we move up in line, she moves up as well. She keeps talking. I'm trying to blow her off. I can obviously tell she wants me to engage with her, get her phone number, or give her my phone number, right? So I start engaging with her just to entertain her, right? Because I'm like, all right, I'm gonna play the game because I know I'm not gonna get knocked off my path. You know, I'm determined to do what I wanna do. So I begin to ask her, you know, does she have a husband? She begins laughing, confirming that she do have a husband. I ask, okay, well, are y'all separated? She begins laughing. It's kind of complicated. So I'm like, okay, so y'all are separated. So y'all are separated. No, can't even answer that. So this lets me know, which I already knew the answer, that you ain't shit. You have a whole husband at home. And you out here trying to find some young penis, some young dick, which I already knew. You know, she didn't even have a ring on her finger. But really, when I asked her, does she have a husband? I already knew because I know how these women are. You know, women will take the ring off their finger just to get some dick, right? And most motherfuckers don't care. And that's, you know, she even admit that's what she did. But also, towards the end of the conversation, I just told her, you know, I'm gonna fast forward. I'll do a story time about that, you know. I'm just giving y'all the basics. But so towards the end of the conversation, I basically tell her, like, you know, I gave her my number and shit, right? Been 100% transparent with y'all. I'm not gonna front. I gave her my number just to play it off. So I tell her, I'm like, okay, such and such, you know, don't get yourself in trouble with your husband. So she started laughing. And then she tells me, she's like, most dudes don't care. She's like, most guys, young guys I fuck with, they don't give a fuck about my husband. They be like, fuck your husband. She's like, you different. I'm thinking I'm different, sweetheart, because I really have no intentions on dealing with you. Like, I gave her my number, but I really have no intentions. And this is the honest truth, King. Like, I don't have to cap for nobody. I'm a grown-ass man, bro. If I wanted to deal with that older woman, I'd deal with her and break her fucking back. You know, I'd deal with her and dick her down. I don't give a fuck. You know, that's why I say, I'm not one of those guys who do semen retention and NoFap as a cult. Well, I believe in NoFap for a lifetime. I ain't gonna lie to you. Like, I don't never want to watch porn again. I don't ever want to masturbate again. So I get that. But with semen retention, in the future, I am going to engage in some vagina. Like, what the fuck? I'm not finna go the rest of my life without sex. If that's what you want to do, I salute you. But me, I believe it should be done. Like I said, I like to do the whole 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 1 year, didn't have sex or whatever the fuck, like, and periodically, you know, in time frames, rather than just like, oh yeah, I'm never having sex again. So I know I'm going on a little rant, but I'm saying all that to say, because I know it'd be somebody in the comment section talking about, damn, you supposed to be on semen retention, why did you give her your number then? Like I just said, I was just entertaining her just to see what her level of frequency was. I wanted to see what vibrational level she was at, because she was basically trying to knock me out my path. So I ran game on her to see what the fuck she had going on. And in that sense, I got to see that she had a whole husband. And then I wanted to see, okay, she has a whole husband, right? Hear me out, she has a whole husband. Let's see how far she's gonna take this. So I give her my number. Damn, she got a whole husband. She's really serious about this shit. She's taking my number down. If she wanted some dick, she'll be calling me for some dick. And this goes back to the intentional, unintentional, which the title is, unintentional motivation of semen retention. Because reason why this ties back into it, because this allowed me, by pushing the envelope to see how far this married woman will go with me, allowed me to see why the fuck I'm on semen retention in the first place, because there's so many trash women out here. So right now, I'm not willing to trade my semen retention for no fucking vagina, for no relationship, for no marriage, because this is how women out here are moving. Not all women, you know, but the majority of them, let's be real, this is how they are, this is how they are out here moving, whether they're married or just in a relationship, or even if they single. That's what that allowed me to see, dealing with that woman. That she was really willing to go that far, and she was, I guarantee you, she was willing to fuck. Because she said other dudes she deal with, which lets me know she deal with multiple young dudes, and she cheats on her husband. Unless they have an open relationship. But all that shit is low vibrational, King. What you are practicing, your semen retention, your journey, is so much more valuable, King. And you're not missing out on shit, trust me. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the Alpha Nation. Share this video with your friends and family to help them become more alpha, to help them become a better version of themselves. Also, if you want one-on-one video consultation, link down in the description. We could talk about anything from nofap to semen retention to female nature, or we could just chop it up about life, man. To next time, Sincere the King. Fucked up. To next time, Alpha Sincere. Y'all know what the fuck I meant. Love y'all. Salute.